1, E has a direct physical sense. Like how? Like I can say that it exerts a force. It exerts a force F equals QE. And the second thing, that it is a measurable, it is measurable, E is directly measurable, and we can measure it on a Q on a test charge. And as long as the deceptive parallel here, the other part of this one, D, so D is basically, D is a mathematical construct. It's a mathematical construct. Like we have constructed a tool which can ease our calculation, which will account only for the free charges. So it is in contrast to this one. Number first, it can't or it doesn't exert a force. Mean it doesn't exert a force, or it cannot store energy directly. It cannot store energy directly. And the other thing is that it is a mathematical construct. It basically it eases the calculation where, because it accounts only for free charges like rho f, sigma f, etc. So it only accounts for the free charges, so it basically eases our calculation. Like I can consider an example, and the example is, let's consider example of a capacitor with dielectric. When we fill a capacitor with a dielectric material, then we will see the role of E and D in this. Now, a parallel plate capacitor with a dielectric. Now, for example, if we fix the free charge, like free charge on a capacitor plate, if it is fixed, then it means D is constant. D is not changing, because D only deals the free charges, and if we fix the amount of free charges, then D is constant. But what about E? When the dielectric is inserted, then E basically drops. E drops by the relative permittivity of the dielectric which we are inserting. So it will drop by 1 over epsilon r due to what? Due to the polarization. The polarization basically drops this, because polarization acts in opposite direction to the external electric field, and that's why it will drop the net value of the total electric field. So it is clear here in this one. Similarly, we can consider another aspect of the boundary conditions. We have discussed in the previous lecture as well. So boundary conditions. Now the boundary conditions are basically the parallel that we can draw between the two, the electric field and the magnet, the electric field and the electric displacement. like both E and D, they have boundary condition. Both E and D have boundary conditions at the interface of the material. Both of these have the boundary conditions. Like, what are those boundary conditions? Like, E parallel is continuous on the interface from one material to another material, and D sigma jumps means it is discontinuous, jumps by sigma F. Because when we come to the surface of the material, then D will jump, D will be different by sigma F. And now let's discuss what is, this is the parallel between the two. Now, what is the deceptive parallel? Means where a deception occurs here. We have the discontinuity. The discontinuity in E, the discontinuity in electric field depends on the surface charges, like both the free and the bound charge, because it's electric field, it deals with both. So I can write that epsilon naught electric field at one material minus the electric field at another material, and this will be equal to sigma F plus sigma bound. The parallel is continuous, while the perpendicular components, it is discontinuous by the total charge. And if I consider the D here, then D, the perpendicular component, is, we say that it is discontinuous, it is having a jump. So D2 perpendicular minus D1 perpendicular equals sigma F only, the free charge. So we can consider an example, and that example we can elaborate why this thing happens. Like, for example, I am considering the interface between two materials, the interface between a conductor and a dielectric, So when I consider the interface between a conductor and dielectric, then inside a dielectric, I know that electric field is zero. E equal to zero inside a conductor. We know this fact that E is zero inside a conductor, and D matches the free surface charge, while D matches with free surface charge. Like, D is having its role on the surface, because we have the, on the surface there is a discontinuity and surface charge is there. So is a final comment on this thing, that basically E is a measurable field which has a direct influence on all types of charges like free and bound, and it is a physical field. It is basically a physical field which is affected by the charges. While when I consider D, then D is not a physical field, but like an auxiliary field. Auxiliary field. And it is not influenced by the charges. It is an auxiliary field which we have tailored for the computational ease. In order to do the calculation easier inside the material, we need D. So this is, this all means we have discussed different aspects that, let me review. From historical point of view, basically the name is wrong. It has nothing to do with the displacement. Like, it is not the displacement of charges, basically. And what does it does? It basically connects the electric field and polarization together, and it accounts for the free charges. We discuss the similarities, the parallel in case of the Gauss's law, and then with the dielectric material we found the deceptive parallel, that what are the differences between the two. We are not supposed to be deceived by that thing. Linearity of material, we discussed that for D equal epsilon E, it's a special case and not a universal truth. Means it depends on the nature of the material. When the material will be linear, homogeneous and isotropic, then it is true. And these are very ideal type of material. Usually we are having a non-linear, like ferroelectric material, anisotropic material, like the crystal, the heterogeneous materials, mean homogeneous material is almost ideal. Then we discuss the physical and mathematical role of the two, that when we have E, then why we need D. So then the mathematical role we have discussed in terms of energy density, how the energy is stored there. E stores energy inside the material, D doesn't store energy directly inside the material. And that E has a physical sense, while it is measurable thing, it can exert force on a charge, we can measure it on a test charge, while D is just a mathematical tool, a mathematical construct which has which doesn't exert any force on a charge, and it cannot store energy directly. The only thing it does is just eases the calculation. And for this we consider the capacitor with a dielectric material, and we came to know that when free charges are fixed, then D is constant, while even if free charges are fixed, E drops by 1 over epsilon R, because polarization will occur in the material and it will cause the external field to oppose due to polarization, and the overall field will drop. Basically, we discuss the deceptive, the parallel and the deceptive parallel in case of boundary conditions, that we have both boundary conditions for E and D, and for E parallel is continuous while D perpendicular is discontinuous. And we consider the example of interface between a conductor and a dielectric material. Inside a conductor, E is zero, while D will match the surface. D will cause the charges. Its role comes on the surface when free charges are the surface, while electric field inside a dielectric is zero. So this is all conceptual discussion. I felt it is necessary in order to discuss the concept of electric field and electric displacement.